In this segment, we'll talk about the graphical derivation of Newton-Raphson method. The Newton-Raphson method is based on finding the root of an equation of f of x equal to 0. So let's suppose if we draw f of x as a function of x here. And what it is based on is that what you're going to do is you're going to say, hey, let me choose the initial guess of x naught, let's suppose, for the root of the equation. You want to get here. Now, what you're going to do is, at this particular point on the function, what you're going to do is you're going to draw a tangent at that particular point. Once you draw the tangent at the particular point, you're going to see, hey, where does it cross the x-axis? So let's suppose that point is x1. And then you're going to repeat this process. You're going to again go here, draw the tangent, and this will become your next guess or next estimate of the root of the equation. As you can see that if you graphically follow this, you want to see that he's getting closer and closer to the root of the equation. That's what the Newton-Raphson method is based on from a graphical point of view. Let's go and use this knowledge to be able to calculate or to be able to derive the formula for Newton-Raphson method. So Newton-Raphson method, let's say we are at, let's suppose, the ith iteration. So it's an iterative process. So let's suppose if this was my the guess or the estimate I have reached at, what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a tangent at that particular point and going to see where it crosses the x-axis. And if it crosses the x-axis, I will call it x of I plus 1, right? Now, what is this point? This point is x of I is the x-coordinate, and the y-coordinate will be the value of the function f at that particular point. And let's suppose if this angle is phi, then we can very well see the tangent phi will be rise over run. And this rise over run will be, hey, what is the rise here? That is nothing but f of xi minus 0. Because if you look at this point, the y value is f of xi, and the y value here is 0. And then we'll divide it by the run, which will be x of I minus x of I plus 1, which will be x of I right here minus x of I plus 1, because that is the run right here. And sometimes students get confused about, hey, do I put x of I plus 1 first and x of I? You got to basically see the rise over run. This is the value of the function x of I, so you put x of I here. That makes perfect sense. It's 0 here, and that's what you have getting x of I plus 1. So what you're going to see is that this tangent phi is nothing but the derivative of the function at x of I, right? Because we are defining the slope of the function at that particular point, or approximating at least, we should say, divided by this. So once we have obtained this, what we got to understand is that the unknown in this whole formula right here, which you are getting for the approximation of the derivative of the function, is this guy right here, because you are starting with some initial guess. You know what the derivative of the function is at that particular point. I shouldn't call it initial guess, but the current estimate. You're starting with the current estimate at this iteration, and you know the value of the function at that particular point. You know the value of the derivative of the function at that particular point. You want to find out what the next estimate of the root is. So the formula which I have is that f of x of I is equal to f of f prime of xi is equal to f of xi divided by xi minus xi plus 1. So I can bring this over there and bring this down here. So I'll get x of I minus x of I plus 1 is equal to f of xi divided by f prime of xi. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this part to the left side. So I'll get this. Move this part to the right side. I'll get x of I plus 1. But what is my unknown? X of I plus 1. And the whole reason why I'm doing all this manipulation is to have unknowns on one side and knowns on the other side. So since we always put unknowns on the left side, so I'm going to put x of I plus 1 here. And I'm just going to switch the sides of the equation. And that's what we get as our Newton-Raphson method formula. So it's a recursive formula. You put the current estimate of the root of the equation and you find the value of the function at that particular point, the value of the derivative of the function at that particular point, and you get your next estimate, and you keep on doing this till you are satisfied that you have obtained a reasonable estimate. So in the next slide, what we do is we will talk about the algorithm of the Newton-Raphson method. So let's talk about the algorithm of the Newton-Raphson method. Of course, we have to keep in mind that what we are doing is we are trying to find the root of the equation f x equal to 0. So the first one, what we have to do is to find f prime of x symbolically. So we have to find the derivative of the left-hand side of the equation, then what we do is we apply this formula to find the next estimate of the root of the equation. And keep in mind that we have to start with some kind of initial estimate. And then what I'm going to do is, do you want to calculate my absolute relative approximator, which is the current approximation minus the previous approximation divided by the current approximation. So I may multiply by 100 if I want to find in terms of percentages. And then what am I going to do with this information? I'm going to say if epsilon A is less than epsilon S or maximum iterations reached, then you're going to say, hey, stop. Else go to step two. So if my absolute relative approximator is less than the pre-specified tolerance, which I have to pre-specify, it could be like a percentage number. I might say, hey, I want a pre-specified tolerance of 0.03%. Or somebody might say, hey, I would like to have at least so many significant digits to be at least correct in my answer. And that can be converted also into a percentage number for the pre-specified tolerance. Or if maximum number of iterations has been reached. What we mean by maximum number of iterations has been reached is because you want to stop the possibility of it going into a long loop. So you will have to put maximum number of iterations for the procedure. But if the algorithm or if the program is stopping because of the maximum number of iterations has reached, make sure that you tell the user that's what has happened, because otherwise they might misinterpret it that you have found the estimate within the pre-specified tolerance. So if either this has happened or this has happened, you will stop, or you will say the estimate of the root has been achieved. Otherwise, you will just go to step two right here, find the new estimate of the root, find the absolute relative approximator, and continue this process. So that's the algorithm for the Newton-Raphson method. And that is the end of this segment.